phages, what do they make you think of?
Zombie-like hordes that infect and destroy their hosts in a mindless effort to replicate. A few scraps of DNA penetrating the host's defense system seizes control of the host cell machinery to create fresh phage proteins and genetic material. The final rupture of the cell wall finishes off the exhausted host, releasing a new batch of viruses ready to infect their next victim.
But phages don't always spell out violent death for their hosts, at least not straight away. Esther Lederberg was the first to discover the existence of prophages, sneaky viruses that pass unnoticed down successive generation of hosts until a timely relaxation of silencing or the crossing with an unwitting new host strain.
As a PhD student, Esther had crossed UV-treated mutant colonies of K12 E. coli on selective media with its parent stock, only to find the surviving recombinants bore the telltale signs of bacteriophage infection. Replicates of the experiment traced the contaminating agent back to the parent stock, which to all accounts appeared perfectly healthy.
For some reason, crossing the stock with its mutagenized kin was releasing a hidden phage. Until Esther's discovery, K12 had been cultivated in laboratories for a quarter of a century without suspicion of harbouring a ticking time bomb. Strains that incorporate these quiescent phages were dubbed lysogenic.
Esther and her partner Joshua Lederberg investigated how the lambda phage could be activated in bacterial conjugation experiments and identified the triggers for phages entering a lysogenic state. Their work culminated in a 1952 paper, Genetic Studies of Lysogenicity in Escherichia coli.
For Lederberg and Lederberg, lysogeny was a biological mystery, but 70 years of research has seen scientists nut out many of the basic details. So let's take a look.
Lambda initiates the lysogenic cycle by expressing C2, a transcription factor. C2 upregulates the expression of Ci, which suppresses further protein expression by lambda. C2 is also a transcription factor for integrase, which facilitates the site-specific integration of the host and phage genomes. When Ci is downregulated by stresses such as UV light or antimicrobials, excision proteins release lambda from the chromosome and the phage enters the lytic cycle once more. In this manner, a cell separated many generations from the point of infection can give birth to an active lambda phage.
Back in 1952, Esther and Joshua Lederberg were dealing with a field of genetics predating many modern tools such as genetic sequencing and engineering. High-tech gene editing for them involved shooting up cells with mutagens like UV light and seeing what survived. What they did have were tools such as recombinant plating and the ability to perform interstrain crosses, transferring genetic material horizontally between two strains, and isolating subsequent recombinants based on their metabolic characteristics.
With this, they aimed to identify the transmission mechanism of lysogenicity from two plausible hypotheses. Either the virus was transmitted as an independent plasmid in the cytoplasm, or it was part of the chromosome itself. Their experiment went like this. Restrictive agars were inoculated with complementary E. coli strains, one being lysogenic and the other lambda-free. All these strains will die on the minimal media, except those that become recombinant prototypes through conjugal gene transfer. The surviving offspring were then screened for lysogenicity and a known genetic trait called galactose auxotrophy. The extremely high frequency of parental types in the surviving colonies allowed the Lederbergs to conclude that the lambda phage was transmitted as a chromosomal factor with an integration point closely linked to the galactose operon. If lysogenicity had instead been a cytoplasmic factor, HFR recombination wouldn't have been expected to transfer the lysogenic trait, and recombination of gal and lysogenicity traits would have been expected.
Lederberg and Lederberg hypothesized that over time, prophages would experience selective pressure in favor of less virulent traits.
This is because the more quiescent a prophage is, the longer it will stably reside in successive generations of its host. Highly virulent phages, however, quickly run through their population of susceptible hosts, bringing an end to their co-evolutionary journey. Over successive loss of virulence mutations, a prophage emerges that is no longer able to be induced into the lytic cycle. Essentially, it was predicted to become just another additional stretch of DNA in its host's chromosome. Genomic analysis has since shown that as much as 16% of E. coli's genome can be traced back to the remnants of 18 distinct prophages integrated in this way. An additional way prophages can actively facilitate bacterial evolution is through specialized transduction. Of particular concern to microbiologists is the potential mediated transfer to oversee the rapid spread of antibiotic resistance in diverse bacterial populations.
There are even indications from mRNA assays that quiescent prophages are modulating their host physiology in cell adaptation responses. From some mysterious spots on an agar plate, the precarious relationship between prophages and their hosts still hold much potential for geneticists and microbiologists.